Welcome back. Joining me once again to discuss Charles Rocher and Carl Struss's innovative and groundbreaking camera work in Sunrise is Robert Yeoman, a cinematographer, member of the American Society of Cinematographers. So we get the happy ending there at the end of Sunrise. In the book, it ends a little differently. Though he doesn't kill his wife by drowning her, he ends up drowning in the lake. But Murnau, in a sign of what was to come over the next 92 years, thought, what if we had a happy ending, right? So you've, I presume, experienced some of that, not directly, because the director is going to deal mostly with the studio, with the producers. But there is, inevitably, the bigger the budget, the more pressure to make it more audience friendly, right?
Yes, definitely. They prefer a happy ending. And To Live and Die in L.A. is a perfect example. Where they kill Billy Peterson, and they're like, "You're killing the hero of the movie." No, you don't do that. You know, in case we want to do To Live and Die Too, you know, and so yeah, it's very rare that you can get away with something like that.
And William Friedkin has the reputation of being a director who you don't box into a corner.
No, Billy has his own, distinct vision of things, and he makes the movie he wants.
We were talking last night about pressure on a director to use a different lens to make the movie.
Yes.
So how did you guys handle that situation?
When Wes and I did Bottle Rocket, we made the decision.
And that was his first movie, so this is the point where the producers think they can push him around.
Wes does not want to get pushed around by anybody, and we made the decision to use a 27mm lens for the whole film. And so when the studio was looking at our camera reports, they saw 27, and they came to me, and they were like, "You can't just shoot the whole movie on one lens." And I said, "Why?" And they said, "You just can't do that, sorry." So we put a little piece of tape on the lens that says 27mm on it. And on our camera reports, we'd put 50, 75, 100mm lens. And one of the producers came up to me after a few days and said, "So you're using different lenses now?" And I said, yeah, we got the 50, the 75. And it was all the same lens the whole movie. So, there's things that you do to kind of protect. I have to protect the director, but they didn't know the difference. So,
right. Robert, great stuff. Thanks very much. Robert will be joining me again next Wednesday night as we continue our salute to the 100th anniversary of the American Society of Cinematographers. Up next tonight, another landmark silent film, director Fritz Lang's Metropolis, with cinematography from Carl Freund, Günter Rittau, and Walter Ruttmann.